1796, created procedures to protect citizens against the smallpox outbreak. In this procedure, he took material from a blister of an infected person and put into the arm of an unaffected person. Also, vaccinations decrease disease outbreak. For example, in 1921, in the United States, 15,000 people died from diphtheria, whereas in between the years of 2004 and 2014, only 2 cases were reported by the CDC. Also, you receive vaccinations between birth and adolescence. In the United States, most children receive 13 vaccinations between that time, whereas stated by the University of Oxford, children in the United Kingdom receive about 19 vaccinations between that time period. So why should you care? You should care because vaccinations save children's lives. Because of advances in medical science, children are now protected against a variety of diseases. Also, vaccinations protect others. Others may not be able to receive vaccinations because they may be allergic to certain ingredients in vaccinations. For example, children who are allergic to eggs are not able to receive the flu vaccination. Also, vaccinations protect future generations. Because of the increasing number of vaccinations we have, it has reduced the number of people killed by vaccinations over a few generations. So now this brings me to my research question of, should the United States lower the amount of vaccinations children receive? I will look at this through 2 possible solutions, which are exempting, which is opting out, and spreading out vaccinations, which is using an alternate immunization schedule. So my first solution would be opting out, which is when a parent refuses one, multiple, or all of the vaccinations their child must receive at that given time period. Why you should opt out, as stated by Dr. Joseph Merkel, a licensed physician and surgeon, you can opt out because of medical reasons, and that medical reason must be approved by MD or VO. You can also opt out because of religious exemptions, which is your constitutional right of freedom of religion. For example, the Catholic Church advises its followers to avoid evil and vaccinations that use aborted fetus parts. And physiological exemptions, which is when an individual holds an objection to all vaccinations. This objection may come from Edward Kessler said, who was the founder of the Wolf Institution, that the internet holds no ethics. So this graph here, given by the National Conference of State Legislators, shows the in the regular blue, the states that hold religious beliefs, and the tribe with the states that hold personal belief exemptions. And as you can see from this graph, there are more states that hold religious belief exemptions than personal belief exemptions. So the implications of opting out, which are medical reactions, as stated by Kevin Lang, an assistant professor of dermatology, vaccinations may cause a number of disorders, including ADHD and OCD. Also, you are also likely to get a disease even with a vaccination. The number of non-vaccinated people outnumber the number of vaccinated people. So limitations of opting out, which would be not being able to attend school. For example, a private school in Michigan have started to refuse children from enrolling because they are not vaccinated. It has come because you are more likely to spread diseases easily when you are not vaccinated, whereas a person who is not more likely to. So now this brings us to solution 2, which is spreading out vaccinations. Spreading out vaccinations, then when you seek an alternate immunization schedule. So in this graph here, according to Immunes for Good, in the top you can see the typical vaccination schedule, which starts at birth, and the bottom you can see in the gray or purple that alternate vaccination schedule, which starts at 2 months. This shows the gap between the amount of vaccinations a child will receive from birth, whereas the typical schedule you receive your vaccination at birth, whereas on the alternate schedule you receive it in about 2 months. Okay, so the implications of spreading out is it increases vaccination rates. So vaccination rates are the estimated number of people with the vaccine who have been vaccinated. So this increases vaccination rate, as stated by Dr. Lawrence Rosen, a pediatrician in primary care, states that a flexible schedule increases vaccination rates. Another implication would be not many vaccinations and doctor visits. So, on average, a child does receive at least 8 vaccinations in 1 doctor visit. This would increase doctor visits also. So, by the age of 15 months, one child would only have 17 shots and would visit the doctor 9 times, whereas a child who had received 8 vaccinations in 1 doctor's visit would probably only have to visit the doctor 3 times to reach that 17 shot limit. So the limitations of spreading out, which would be there's a lower risk of negative side effects, as stated by Elizabeth Richardson, who has an MSc. A 2013 study showed that 80,000 children who received vaccinations at the recommended age of between 12 and 15 months had a lower negative side effect than those children who did not receive those vaccinations at that time. Also, you're more vulnerable to diseases for a longer period of time. For example, children between the ages of 3 months and 3 years old who have missed a shot, who have gotten the shot late, are 28 more times likely to get the whooping cough disease. Also, this is not the best way to help keep down the number of vaccinations. This is not the best way because at the end of the day, if you're getting vaccination on an alternate schedule or if you're getting on a regular schedule, some parents are scared that vaccinations will harm their children. Also, their vaccinations cause problems and health problems. For example, because of the myths that have been said about vaccinations causing ADHD or OCD disorders and even cancer have scared parents into not letting their children get vaccinated. Also, they do health problems. They help decrease the amount of people who get sick when an outbreak does occur. Also, regulations need to be put in place to stop the amount of vaccination that children receive at one time. There are regulations in place for all 50 states that tells us that we need to have vaccinations to enter school, but there are no regulations stopping the amount of vaccinations that we need that we receive in one doctor's visit. And this is all
started. Well done. We get started with the questions. Oh, yes. The first question, what information did you need that you were not able to identify or locate, and how did you go about trying to find that information?
One thing that I was not able to locate was another solution. I have 2 solutions that I presented today, but I felt like because most parents want their child to get vaccinated, there was not many solutions as to why you should stop getting vaccinated. This hindered my presentation because I wasn't able to present to you more evidence about why you should not be able to get vaccinations.
And then the second question, what additional questions emerged from your research and why are these questions important?
What questions emerged from my research was, why aren't there more personal studies about how vaccinations affect their children, whereas only the studies that I found were based on ones that the CDC had conducted. There were no really personal studies of how parents had made a blog or a website stating how their children were affected by the side effects of vaccinations.
Thank you very much.